Before I speak to motion, it bears repeating that all people deserve dignity, respect, and compassion. Study after study indicates the hardships that transgender individuals endure. Withholding facts and denying truth, however, only serve to further the pain, suffering, and isolation already experienced by some. It is not our job on this committee to engage in politically correct rhetoric, but to support all students and present the facts in a clear, impartial, and most importantly, scientifically accurate manner. The premise upon which this committee replaced sex with sex assigned at birth was that biological sex was meaningless. Here is a list of resources that I have that I will pass along that continue to refer to biological sex. The scientific and medical community have used this term throughout history as they understand that biology is not bigotry. Organizations like the American Psychological Association, National Institute of Health, World Health Organization continue to respect biological fact in addition to considering ideological trends. The World Health Organization states biological sex and socially constructed genders interact to produce differential risks and vulnerability to ill health and difference in health-seeking behaviors and health outcomes for women and men. It then goes on to discuss the biological difference between men and women. The APA uses the term sex, stating that it refers to a person's biological status and is typically categorized as male, female, or intersex. There are a number of indicators of biological sex, associated primarily with physical attributes such as chromosome, hormone prevalence, and external and internal anatomy. The most recent U.S. study of 6,456 trans patients, the multi-center STRONG study, referenced biological sex and states, transgender people are a diverse group of individuals whose biological sex does not match their gender identity. The STRONG study further uses the term natal sex, which shows that sex assigned at birth is not universally used. Additionally, the National Academy of Sciences Committee on the Understanding the Biology of Sex and Gender states that sex begins in the womb at the moment of conception, followed by well-established processes of differentiation between the two sexes. Biological sex is either male or female, is an undeniable and irrevocable medical reality. However, an exceedingly rare number of individuals with a medical diagnosis of disorder of sex development, or intersex, do require sex assignment. But it is absurd to deny the reality of biological sex on a rare developmental disorder that exists only among few. Interestingly enough, the APA itself realizes that some categories of transgender definitions are fluid. Exact definition of these terms vary from person to person and may change over time, but often include a sense of blending or alternating genders. Because most medical and scientific organizations continue to use the term biological sex, and since transgender definitions may be fluid and subject to change, biological sex should be used in a broad-based FLE curriculum to ensure consistency and scientific accuracy. I'm sorry. The NIH also emphasizes the importance of biological sex in research. One of the fundamental variables in preclinical biomedical research is sex, whether cell, tissue, or animal, female, or male. Biological sex is an important consideration for this research that underlies drug development, clinical trials, and prevention. There are thousands of medical journals and articles addressing differential impact of drugs based on sex, from diabetes drugs to sleep aids, digestion, pain meds, hormone therapy, to chemotherapy. To cite one, Professor of Psychiatry at Columbia University and chair of the APA scientific program explains that antidepressants have different impacts according to sex. Because of sex differences, women should take only half as much Ambien as men. Clearly, biological sex is not meaningless. Biology and not ideology should be taught throughout the curriculum. Sex assigned at birth is not scientifically accurate. It is a term designed to create an ideological premise. Truth and fact among the scientific and medical community should not be suspended to further a political agenda or particular ideology. Using the universally recognized term biological sex in our curriculum must preside, as this is a framework in which our society and school system